around Australia to stop this torture.
Nauru, Australia's only remaining offshore detention.
They say that they made offshore processing so that they could stop people drowning in sea. What's the point of surviving in sea if you die here?
Currently, 107 people are held by Australia on Nauru Island, waiting to be resettled. Most have been there for more than 8 years. It costs Australian taxpayers more than $4 million per year to hold a single refugee on Nauru. That's a little more than $11,000 per person per day. Construct International, the company behind the program, has just posted a $101 million profit.
The people who are subject to offshore processing are caught in the middle of a political fight between the major political parties in Australia about who's in control, who's tougher than who.
Since 2014, no new asylum seekers have been sent to Nauru. Yet the running costs of this system are the same as they were when it held more than 1,000 people.
I think most Australians would be mystified as to why thousands and thousands of dollars are being spent every day to keep people in situations where, you know, life is quite miserable and people are just desperately waiting for an answer for their resettlement options.
The costly program has been marred by controversy, with reports of alleged violence and staff sexually abusing children as young as six when they were held at the centre.
The indefinite offshore detention has destroyed their resilience, shattered all hope, and ultimately impacted their mental health.
A child the other day covered herself in petrol and was stopped from setting fire to herself.
Now, you might think having racked up $337 billion worth of pandemic-related debt, the federal government would be looking for some savings. But in September, it signed a new agreement with Nauru, stating it now creates an enduring form of offshore processing.
In practical terms, continuing to hold people in Nauru and in PNG and in limbo in Australia and in detention in Australia serves absolutely no purpose.
But having stopped the flow of boat arrivals, is it finally time to stop the flow of cash into a cruel and controversial system?
I mean, it doesn't matter how you look at the offshore processing situation, there's no argument for keeping it open. There's not a moral argument for keeping it open, doesn't matter how you spin it, and there's not an economic argument for keeping it open.
No, but Scott Morrison's got the argument that he wants to go to this election as the guy that stopped the boats all those years ago. He's not going to give that up now.
No, and I don't expect him to, but that is an argument that he's made for political expediency. That is not a moral argument. And it's funny you mentioned Scott Morrison, actually, because he was under a lot of pressure to make the rapid antigen tests free, at least to people who were low-income earners or people that really needed them. And he was interviewed about it and he said, well, you know, we can't make them free because every time someone tells you they're going to make something free, actually someone always pays for it and that person is you. So the insinuation there is that he doesn't want to put any undue pressure on the taxpayer to pay for things that the taxpayer does not have to pay for. And yet we have 107 people essentially incarcerated indefinitely on Nauru at a cost of what ends up being $428 million a year that the taxpayer is going to have to front. How do you justify that?
Jan-Fran, don't you think we did this? I mean, the stop the boats policy wasn't hidden. It was a showpiece of an election, and the majority of Australia voted for it.
Sure, but if you're sitting here claiming that you care about taxpayer money and taxpayer money being wasted, I just don't see how you could possibly justify this level of taxpayer funding for an institution that is cruel, inhumane, utterly unnecessary and can be changed like that.
Jennifer, I completely agree with you, but I think that's what you have to remember when you cast your vote.
And there's an election coming up.